Whether you want to make your MIDI tracks less robotic, or maybe you just need to make that MIDI fit in with your current project, MixCraft 10 gives you the tools to help you easily do all of this. So let's jump in and take a look at some of the MIDI tools that you might use most often. Let's look at some very common MIDI tools that MixCraft 10 puts right at the tip of our fingers. And we're going to look at this MIDI clip right here. It's a drum clip. I'm just going to solo it. You can hear what it sounds like. Very basic little drum kit. Now, if I right click on it, you're going to see in this dialog menu, some MIDI editing tools right at our fingertips. So you just right click and let's say we wanted to quantize it. We could press that and it's going to bring up our quantize window where we could quantize by eighth note, whatever it is we want to quantize by. We could do that easily from there. Let's right click again. And you can see human eyes. And that's kind of what I want to look at with this clip is the human eyes. So let's just dig a little deeper. We're going to go into the clip by double clicking on it and it brings up all this info down here. And if you click on the undock, it makes the window a lot bigger. So you can just zoom in on here if you want and you can see all of our MIDI data very easily. And you'll notice with this one, everything is right on beat, which is okay, but it's a little robotic. So you might want to give it a little more humanistic kind of feeling because humans don't hit everything right exactly on beat every time. There's going to be slight little variations. So we're going to click dock again. And now what I'm going to do is right click, click on humanize. And now we can see in here, we have some settings that we can adjust to make this a little more human. And you have your max adjustment and that's by milliseconds. So you don't want to get too crazy with this. You can play around with these settings to see what works best for your particular MIDI clip. I do recommend random, but the other options here are you can have it so it's always early or always late. Random gives you sometimes early, sometimes late, just like a human. And then down here you have note velocities. So this MIDI clip wasn't just created in the piano roll. I didn't click each of these. It was recorded in. So the velocities here are all right. But if all of your velocities were the same level, you're going to want to randomize those as well. But for this clip, I'm going to leave that off. So let's just try the settings that I have in here right now. I'm going to click OK. And you saw that it did ever so slightly move some things. So you can see this one here is just a little ahead. Same with that one there. This one here is a little bit behind. So it's a little more humanistic. Let's give this a listen now. I will turn that off. And then let's put it back on. It's just so slight, but the human ear likes to have that little bit of randomness in there. If everything's exactly the same all the time, the human ear is going to tune it out. And it was all done by right-clicking on our MIDI clip and then going to humanize. You can also see the other MIDI editing tools that we have directly from a right-click. So there's quantize, humanize, transpose, edit velocities, edit offsets, edit durations, soloize, and double selected MIDI clips. Lots of stuff you can do directly from a right click, which is really cool. But now I want to look at some things with this clip right here, and it's on this horn flange instrument. So let's just listen to this. It's just not sounding right with our song right now. And how we can easily and quickly fix that is we're going to double click on the clip here. And it's bringing up our MIDI edit window. And if you're like me, you might want to undock this so you can see it a little easier. This makes things a lot nicer to work with if you're just editing the MIDI, which is what we're going to be doing right now. And we can see this is set to transpose, which means we could easily transpose it by using the tools here. But what we want to do is just quickly match our project key. So now let's just dock this again and we'll listen from the start. Still doesn't really sound like it's fitting in. And that could be because it thinks that the original clip key is C, and that's what our project is, C. So it hasn't really changed anything. And you can see on here, luckily, it tells us that the original clip was B minor. So if you get this in a clip pack, like that's where I found this, hopefully it tells you what the original key is, or you can just have a look and figure it out if you need to. So we're going to click in this section here. We're just going to bring it back, and then I'm just going to change this over here to minor. And now let's just give this a listen. All right, so that fits in a lot better than what it sounded like before. Now let's go to the next clip that I want to look at, and that's this second drum part over here. So let's give this a listen. All right, so that drum beat is way off and it makes the bass sound way off. So we're going to double click on that, see what's going on in here. And we have it set to time stretch, which means it hasn't done anything to the tempo of this clip. So let's click on Use Project Tempo. Now we'll give that a quick listen. That's not too bad. Let's duplicate that a couple times. All right, that would be usable right there. And it was just a quick click of Use Project Tempo. And one of the cool things, if we were to use the project tempo and also use the project key, if we were to do a key change in the middle of our song, say we put a marker here, did a key change, this would follow along with that key change. Or say we go back here, we don't like the key of C. Now, if we change this to, let's say, the key of E, it's changed this, and it's also changed our bass because it's also using Use Project Key. So everything is changing with that. Next up, we're going to look at some advanced automation. So I'll see you in the next video.